Dear students, today we will discuss about software documentation. So a software system is of a little use unless people can learn to use and maintain it. So the system has been built and system has been given to the user. So if this is the responsibility of the user to install, to maintain, or it is of course their responsibility to use that system, so there should be a documentation explaining each and everything about software. So such documentation could be in the form of manuals when talking about particularly the documentation for users. So we will discuss the documentation into three different types: user documentation, system documentation, and technical documentation. So what is user documentation? This explains the features of the system or software and describe how to use them to the users. It is intended to be read by the user of the software and is therefore expressed in a particular, in the similar fashion, in related to that particular terms. We should use only those terms which the user should be aware of. We should not use the technical language. We should not use anything which is related to internal structure of software or software components, etc. So we should talk in a way that we are talking to a layman. So such a documentation is prepared, and this documentation, user documentation, is recognized as an important marketing tool. So the systems, softwares which have such user documentation are attracting more people to buy that product, and it increases the sale. Many software developers hire technical writers to produce this part of their product. So normally the software programmers are mainly focusing on the development, and the technical writers are writing the technical aspects or the documentation for the users. Then there is another type of documentation known as system documentation. This describes the software's internal composition so that the software can be maintained later in the life cycle. So we comment different lines. So for example, you have written one module, and at the top of the module you need to explain that I am writing this module. This module will perform this, 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 and doesn't do this, this, this. So all of such things are commented out within the source code, within the programming lines, so that if new person want to make changes to that software, that can understand. Similarly, we should also use indentation to make the code look more logical, more structured. So for example, if there is a loop which we discussed in one of the modules, then any statement within that loop should be little bit given more space and should be ident to cover within the body of that loop. So we should write the programs in a way that it can be understood very well. And then we should also use the naming conventions. All organizations mostly have their own naming conventions, that for example, whenever you want to define any variable, it should start with this word. If you want to define any module, it should start with this action verb, and so on. So all of these standards should also be maintained. And then there is a third type of documentation known as technical documentation. This describes how a software system should be installed. That's it. So adjusting operating parameters, what configuration settings you can perform, installing updates, reporting problems back to the software's developer. So if we summarize today's module, we have learned about documentation. We have learned that there are three types of documentation: user documentation, system documentation, and technical documentation.